We're at the Dinosaur National Monument. This is an area called the Dinosaur Quarry. It's supposed to have an exhibit in here with lots of dinosaur bones as they were found in their natural state.
Did you spot the dinosaur?
We're going to go inside, yeah, and see. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All the bones in this rock quarry wall here are real. Millions of years ago, when these dinosaurs were dying, this ground was flat. And then as the Rocky Mountains rose, other mountains started rising, this flat land tilted. And then when they dug into this hillside here, all these bones appear as they do in the video here. But it used to be flat ground. Skull of an Allosaurus. There's a replica of what the skeleton that they removed from here looked like. They're meat eaters, of course. There's a big mouth here that'll bite you real hard if you don't drop money in the box. This is still in Dinosaur National Monument. We stopped for lunch on a little turnout overlooking the Green River and the surrounding hills. There's a campground down below there. And somebody's got a farm. It's like they raise alfalfa maybe, or hay. There's Karen studying a sign. Hi. This is an area called Split Rock on the Green River, which flows at the base of the rocks there. Inside Arches National Monument. It's in the morning, a little after 10. This place is really pretty. The rock formation over there is called the Three Gossips. Sheep Rock in the middle. Oregon Rock. There's a balanced rock way out there. I'm going to drive over that way.
This formation is called the Three Gossips.
Another view of the Three Gossips. Sign over here says there's once an arch. That rock straight ahead, upper left, used to be an arch and ran across and joined on that hillside. This rock's called a sheep rock. Left side, you can, looks just like a sheep's face. Really amazing. We're still driving the big loop. Be heading over in that direction here. In a little while, the road curves around. There's an area called Double Arch over there. We should get a lot closer to it. It's pretty interesting looking. It's called Balanced Rock. It's amazing how all that weight can stay balanced there. It looks like it's gonna crumble off to one side. It's really amazing. Man, looks like it's just gonna go falling off to the left there. Amazing. Going up to an area here called Double Arch. Yeah, this is kind of how an arch starts. Starts weathering out of a softer material, starts to weather out. Gets to where it looks kind of like this, and water seeping in from the back. Ice and wind and what have you. Finally all erodes away and you wind up with something like this. Sure is. I wonder how old they are.
Probably about as old as me.
I think they're a little older. We're up under, what is this called, window arch?
Yeah, window arch.
Which goes up over our heads. These rocks look like they're about ready to come out, land on our heads.
Crash, smash.
I call it Turret Arch. We're on a little trail now, heading towards South Window. The one we just came from is called North Window. It's over there behind the boulder. For mountain sheep. There's one. Bah! Bah! Down we go. This is called Skyline Arch. Back in 1940, a big boulder section fell out of the left side of it, about doubled the size of the arch. We're heading south on Highway 163 in Utah. We're almost to the Badlands. We're almost to Monument Valley. Just stopped to have some lunch. Some real pretty scenery around. The colors on that hill. Balancing rock over here somewhere. Here it is. I think. How's that for a balancing act? Yeah, this is some of the scenery in Monument Valley. We'll be staying overnight here at an RV park. More Monument Valley. Beautiful. Here's a little view from our campsite in Monument Valley. It's looking out through a canyon. We're back up inside of a canyon. the LD. Sun is dropping down behind me here at the old campground. It's really pretty. These buttes are really huge. You don't realize how big until you look at the vehicles around. There's a water truck down there. Well, September 22nd, we're going to be leaving tomorrow morning. This big dust storm came up yesterday afternoon. It's lasted on through today. Here's the same view where I videotaped the buttes from here the other day, and all you see now is dust. They're out there somewhere. See the dust in the air here. This is 6:45 in the morning, just before sunrise, Monument Valley.
September 23rd, and we're on the road again. We're on the windy, dusty road. It doesn't look too bad right here, but we've had some real bad winds out here in good old Monument Valley. Coming up behind us is something called the Rotel. It's a bright red bus-type sleeper truck from Germany. It has Germany written on the back, and it's really interesting because it looks like they people tour and sleep on this thing. So when they come by us, we'll get a shot of them if we can. He just pulled out. We're in Cayenta, little town. He just pulled out and he's coming around. They have a driver and they also have a tour fellow right there in the passenger seat with a microphone. See, this side you can't see the windows. On the left side, there's three rows of windows, like they sleep in layers. I just cannot imagine sleeping in this. There's the windows. So there must be like a little hall on the right side. And down here it says, you can read it, Germany. Isn't that amazing? Look at them colored rocks, would you, Bruce? I'm going to go over. Go over the Colorado River. Feet above the river.
River's way down.
Wow. That's a big dam.
Glen Canyon Dam. This bridge is 700 feet above the water.